Welcome to clickmyproject.com. The title of the project is Time Series Database Pre-Processing for Data Mining Using Python.
The abstract of the project is data processing lays the groundwork for data mining. Before the discovery of useful information knowledge, the target data set must be properly prepared. Using data mining in census data has very high learning value and waste marketplace space. While census data are being collected and accumulated at dramatically high rates, concept hierarchically, one of the data mining techniques can be used to reduce the data by collecting and replacing low-level concepts with higher-level concepts. Data preprocessing lays the groundwork for data mining, yet most researchers unfortunately ignore it. This project walks through the process of analyzing the characteristics of daily minimum temperature dataset. The unified data model is used as a standard representation for the incoming data so that it can be mined. It not only provides flexibility for data processing but also reduces complexity and difficulty of preparation for mining customer survey data. Time series analysis is the preparatory step that is needed to develop the future values. Through the series analysis, we can understand different structure of the inherent nature of the series so that we can create an accurate forecast. The data was decomposed into the base level, trend, seasonal and residual components. Finally, the data stationary status was checked using Dickey-Phillips stationary test, and the test shows the data is stationary. The flow diagram of time series data is start the project and select the temperature data and air passenger data as the input. We use the temperature data of Melbourne, Australia and air passenger data set. The temperature data set is based on date and temperature, and air passenger data set is based on date and passenger ID, and take the data set into pre-processing method. In pre-processing method, we are going to forecasting the temperature time series data set. Then it will be processed into stationary test. In stationary test, RMX model is used to find the coefficient and say standard coefficient value of the data. Then finding the residual value of temperature and air passenger data set. Then it processed into augmented Dickey-Phillips test. In augmented Dickey-Phillips test, is going to find the mean value and variance value of the air passenger data set based on temperature. All the results are shown in graphical representation as the plot. I am going to run my program in Anaconda Navigator Spider IDE. Checking null values in air passenger data set and checking null values in temperature in Melbourne data set. This is number of air passenger versus date plot. This is Melbourne temperature in 10 years of data set. This is plot visualization. This is ARIMA model to finding coefficient values and standard error values. This is partial autocorrelation graph. This is residual values of air passengers in Melbourne. This is autocorrelation visualization by using CERIMAX model. In CERIMAX model, we are going to find coefficient and standard error, minimum and maximum 0.25% error and 97% error. This is standard residual visualization. This is histogram visualization. Histogram plus estimated density visualization. This is normal quantity visualization. This is correlogram visualization. This is passenger step ahead forecasting passenger plot. in 10 years. The mean square error of our forecast is 85.41. The root mean square error of our forecast is 9.24. This is mean square error plot. Test mean square error is 1848.084. An augmented Dickey filter test. Thank you.